I want to show you how to add animation to your loaded entity in visionOS, and also how we can create a volumetric window. So first we need to create an app, and there are basically two ways of doing that. So let's start with the name. Let's call it Orbit Animation, because in this example I will show you how to perform the orbit animation. And what is important here is that you should select a volume, because it will just enable automatically in the configuration file the information for the scene that the default is a volumetric one. So let's save it. Okay. So as you can see here in application scene manifest, we have volumetric window application session role. But there could be a different example here that you will just create a new project, but without the volume initial scene selected. So you will have a plain example here, so with animation plane, and this way it will not create anything like information about the window here. So this value must be of course updated to volumetric window application session role. Okay. But I think we can start right now. So first of all, let's just load this application to see if all is working fine. There should be a sphere. Okay, we have it. Okay, let's come a little closer. Okay, so looks like it is working. So first of all, let's remove the from here the window style is volumetric. This is fine, but I want to increase the size of the box which the application is. So the default is 1 meter high and 1 meter in width and in depth. But here I'm just changing the values to 2 meters on each side. Okay, let's save it, and let me just paste my code into the content view, and let's look what is going on here. So at the beginning we have a reality view, which is our Swift UI component for loading content from USDZ file. And first is we have this entity initializer, which is an async. So for now, I will be loading an entity 3D model, which is inside Dragon Animation Flying, which I will upload later. So what's going here is that this scene which will be loaded where the dragon is, we are going to put it inside another entity. That entity will have a position changed to be a little bit lower than the zero area, because the animation for the dragon is like it's going upper and upper. So first of all, we need to wait till the entity is loaded, and we need to decrease the size of the model, and we of course are going to add our dragon model entity into the entity which we created here. So after that, we are going to create an orbit animation with the duration to 5 seconds. We then specify the axis, that the field which will be taken into account when the model will be orbiting. What is important here is that each entity has different components. One of them is transform. So what we are going to do here is setting the start transform to our entity position. We are going to bind the target with the transform parameter, and we also would like to have this animation in infinite mode. Okay, so after the orbit animation is created, we are generating from it the animation resource, and then we just play the animation. This prepared entity could be already added to our content, so to our RealityView root content view. And also we have this available animation inside the dragon, which is just a flying animation. So we can also start the animation here. So, of course, at the beginning, let me just add the USDZ file. Okay, looks promising. Let's start the application. Okay, it looks like it is flying. Yeah, and if you look closer, it is indeed changing the orbit animation in the, I believe, Y axis. All right. Keep in mind that this is a beta version of Xcode 15 beta number 8, and there could be issue, for example, when you're trying to load here an entity from another bundle. In my Xcode, I have the issues that I cannot load anything from, for example, related content. What I can do is just put it into the main bundle of the application, then it works. Otherwise, the animation, it will load something, but the animation will not be performed. So I hope that it will be fixed soon. So if you enjoyed the video, please subscribe, follow me, and see you again later.